Welcome to Forest Trump channel, and that's my third attempt to find a place to build my own dugout. First two attempts were not so successful, so now I went to taiga, not very deep actually, but still. And I'm gonna check a place which is called Cordon Bergamac. It is in the western Siberia, quite far away from my home. I decided to go there because on a map it looks pretty interesting. Honestly, I don't know what to expect. This might be an abandoned village. Actually, I think it is. A friend of mine once told me that there are some hermits living there, but it was 7 years ago and I'm not sure whether they're still there. So probably I'm gonna check it. The initial idea was to find a place that is suitable for building a dugout with internet. So I intend to have a place literally to live in all seasons. So I can't just go into the wild, find an abandoned shack or something else. It's quite challenging. We are not deep into taiga now, but still this place can be dangerous. Locals say there are some bears, but I honestly doubt it because we are not so far away from civilization. Anyway, I'm going to be the first tourist to check it here probably. That might be from locals, eaten by a bear. Probably. There might be very strong winds over here. Look at this, this birch tree is approximately 2 feet wide and still broken. I should be careful in finding a place to put my tent today. The first creek on my way. It seems pretty clean, but I still have some water, so I'm not gonna check it now. This road is not so good after heavy rains, so that's what villagers do. They get tractors over here, and they just grab some soil and fix this road. And they also built a little bridge across that creek. I probably passed 5 or 6 miles already and I'm still 7 or 8 miles away from a place where I'm going to. Got tired, honestly. I go hiking a lot, but I have been ill for the last couple of weeks, so now it's quite challenging for me and the backpack is freaking heavy. I guess 17 kilos. As far as I know, you call it fireweed. In Russia we call it Ivan Chai. And we do use it for preparing tea. But I never tried, unfortunately. This wire line is an indicator that I do everything right, because it's supposed to go almost to Cardon Bergamac. No roads anymore. Now I'm going by a wire line. And recently I've seen a truck that takes the logs out of the forest. It's a good sign. It means that further I'll see good pine woods with straight logs suitable for building a dugout. But now I'm struggling not to be eaten by mosquitoes here. I have to go quick. Much more fun with my anti-mosquito dress on. Luckily it's not hot outside. Now I look like a typical prepper. Oh no, but my blue backpack spoils everything. An hour ago, I ran out of all roads, but now I ran out of even a wire line. So finally I have to go across a forest. I go west and it's halfway to Cardon Bergamac. It is supposed to be an ultralight tent, you know, but 1 kilo and 60 grams, I don't think it's ultralight, but for my purposes it's perfect. I always take it because in most cases I go alone, all my friends are busy at work, at study, so I had to choose something that will fit me perfectly. And I guess that's the best I could do, because it only costs like 10,000 rubles in dollars, I don't know, it's approximately 100 and a half. Pretty cheap tent, easy to use and quite reliable. And that's how it looks like. So you can see that it's a pretty narrow tent. It's only 2 feet wide and 3 feet tall. Oh, I'm sorry for the sun. It's enough for me. I'm a very tall guy, almost 7 feet tall. So it's basically one of the few tents where I can lie without curving my legs. That's why I really appreciate it. As you can see, it is a summer variant because it has a very good ventilation here. There is a ventilation window over here and on the other side. And also one of the features of this tent is its door. it's made of net. So it's impossible to use it in winter because obviously it's really cold over there, but in summer it's a nice variant. I'm a Russian forest tramp, but not a Russian forest bum, you know. That's why I do not avoid taking good equipment when I go hiking. And that's my sleeping bag. This is indeed an ultralight one. It weighs only 700 grams. And you remember, I'm 7 feet tall, so that's good. Of course, it is not made of any synthetic, for sure. And I'm able to use it in summer whenever I want, because the comfort temperatures are approximately from 9 degrees to 4 degrees Celsius. I don't know how much is it in Fahrenheit, you can calculate by your own. But that's how it looks like. Really, really nice sleeping bag, and I even tried to use it in winter, but it was hardcore, it was really hardcore, because in winter, you know, in Siberia, in my part of it, it gets really cold, approximately minus 20 or even minus 30 degrees Celsius. So I had to get into this sleeping bag and to another one, like two layers. The first is synthetic and the second one is this. And still I have to be in all the clothes I take with me. But with it, I am still able to have good sleep at night, you know. That's hardcore, that's surviving in Russia. Speaking about food for today, I wanted to go for 3 or 4 days, so I didn't take much. I guess today I'm going to have this pasta, you know, very cheap one. I'm sure you have something like this in the USA, just food for bums. I also have some sausages. Like this. It doesn't spoil for a long time, so it's just a perfect food for hiking. I have some dry bread over here, just a little bit. Obviously a spoon, some tea, some spices. I always take only dry spices because they do not weigh anything. I have some porridge. For a couple of times, that's enough. And what I like most is this soup. It's a dry one. Such a box is enough for having a nice meal for a couple of times, so it's my favorite food actually. And I guess what you like most are these small guys. Yes, you can write in comments what do you think they are. I'm sure you won't guess. Basically, these are little bottles of ethanol, 95%. That's what I drink when it gets really hard, you know. It is not vodka, it's pure ethanol. But right now there is just some sugar inside. And coffee. I don't want to take risks. I have only 2.5 liters of water left, and the bergamot is still quite far away. So I'm gonna boil it like this. This is a type of thing that is used in Russian army. It was invented actually in 1940s. It was for sure used by the Nazi army. But the construction was so successful that it was copied by Soviet soldiers and soldiers of many other armies. That's why it is still used. But the first day is over. Approximately 7 miles are behind me and 7 miles are in front of me. I'm an early bird, so now it's just 9 o'clock in the evening, but I already want to sleep. I know that if I wait, there will be much more mosquitoes, and I don't want them to be my neighbors this night. So, good night, everyone. Morning, everyone. Had a really nice sleep. It was not hot, was not cold, just an ideal weather. It's 7 o'clock and I'm afraid I won't be able to have a normal breakfast as I have just a couple of liters water left. I'll have to save it. So now I'll just try to dry my tent and go further. I have to put food in pockets is because of bears, obviously. It's very dangerous if you try to keep all your sausages in your tent. You know, one time a bear can just come and eat you and your food. I don't want to take risk. And as for my cap, when you are in taiga, in my part of Siberia especially, it is better if you put it like this. Because if you do not overlap it, there is a risk that there will be some mice that can come into it and shit there. And the mice in Western Siberia are spreading many different diseases, and they are quite dangerous. Some of them are even deadly. Forest is more wet now. Recently I have passed a very, very little swamp. It was not a good experience, much more mosquitoes over there. And right now I am quite afraid of bears, because here I see some berries growing up. And I know that berries are the main food for bears. So I have to walk and Misho! And shout. Bears do not like human speech. Chaga mushrooms growing on trees. These mushrooms are used for making tea, and it's good business for locals because One big pack of such mushrooms costs 1,500 rubles, which is something like 20 bucks. In this part of Russia, that's big money. Walking across a little ravine. I'm afraid of ravines for two reasons. First one is water. The second one, more mosquitoes. This is a small one, but I know that on my way there will be a bigger raven showed on a map. I don't know how can I cross it. Probably there will be some trees that fell across it. As for the maps that I'm using when hiking, they are called Soviet military maps. They were created approximately 50 years ago, and they are still considered one of the most accurate maps that can be used for Russia. The interesting fact about them is that they show not only the territory of former USSR in all the details, but also the lands of Western countries, because they were created during Cold War. But unfortunately now there are more trails that are not depicted on the maps. Some villages disappeared. Sometimes they can be misleading. Houston, we have problems. Now I have to go across a very, very thick forest. Young trees staying so close to each other that it's very difficult to find a trail. I'm approximately 200 meters away from a ravine and I see that the forest is going down. Probably this was all one big mistake and I won't be able to cross it here, but I should try. The ravine is behind me. It was quite deep, but instead of a creek, it was just a little swamp. So it was quite easy to cross it, not taking account of mosquitoes and wet, high grass. And now I'm going high the hill on the opposite side. And my purpose is to find a road. It should be approximately 3 miles away from me. This road will lead me to Kardon Bergamak. I'll show you the forest. You can see all these pines are standing in one line. It means that they were put here years ago in order to restore this forest. I can suppose that previously it was used to take the logs out, and after all old pines were moved from this place, forest men just decided to restore it by growing other pines. Russian forest. Now this is a real taiga. Pine trees, very few birch trees, a lot of mosquitoes, wet grass, ravines and creeks. I'm so happy that that creek is behind, because now I just have to walk across forests, across hills, without huge problems that were waiting me down there. The grass there was taller than me. I was unable to video it because it was just unbearable to move down there. I am getting tired and running out of water. I only have a liter and a half. I guess I will be able to get new water closer than Bergamak, because there are still some more or less clean creeks over here. The only problem is to get there. Walking along a forest defensive line. They dig some trenches across forests. And the idea is to protect them from being burned all in one time. So for example, if the fire is on the left, it is harder for it to go to the right if there is a trench like this on the way, because there is few grass. Right now for me it is a real salvation, because according to the map this forest defensive line goes straight to the road to Bergamak, and I am right now 2 miles away from it, which really makes me happy. That's what true Russians drink next to Cordon Bergamak. Indicator that I'm going right way. Look at this moss. It is so soft. I know that it has some antiseptic properties and it can be used for filtering water as well. Really, really nice. An interesting place. I have no idea what does that mean. But here there is a double forest defense line. Probably it is a border of some kind of land. Like a crossroads, forest crossroads. I need to go there. Infrastructure in this forest is too developed to build a dugout. I mean, it's very easy to get here. I see a lot of empty packs of cigarettes, bottles of vodka. You know, all these signs that make you understand that you're in Russia. Let's see how Cordon Bergamak looks like. Moose footprints. Not an adult one, I suppose, because if it was an adult moose, the footprint would be almost as long as my foot. It went that way, and I am coming opposite. This forest is dead. It was burning from roots to the tops. Quite sad. This road will lead me to Tara River. It's quite a big river. And Bergamak Creek falls into it. I am still approximately 4 miles away from Bergamak, but the road is very good, so I'm having a rest. Rest from mosquitoes, rest from hardcore hiking across taiga. That's nice. Like a border between death and life. Burnt forest ends. Living forest begins. Finally, Tara River. Have some. And somebody's pants. So far it's the most suitable place to build something. There is a river, and I'm pretty sure that it has a lot of fish, at least That's what I heard from locals. Pine trees, very nice. There is internet, by the way, and the nearest village over there is just 2 miles away. So if I need, I can just cross a river and go there to buy something, to go back to city. I'm going to check forests nearby. What bothers me is that they are burning quite often. That's what I see. I don't want my dugout to be burned by some drunk locals or whatever else. Cordon Bergamac is approximately 2 miles in that direction. I'm going to check it anyway because my purpose is to go 10 miles to the north back to the automobile road. I will have to do it anyway. Very, very peaceful place. One of the most beautiful places I have seen. Locals cut trees that fell on the road. That means that this road is still widely used. Maybe Cordon Bergamac is not as abandoned as I thought it is. Bergamac. That's an old bridge. A destroyed one. Destroyed by crazy ATV drivers. Cordon Bergamac looks like this. It is still inhabited. So what are the interim results? First of all, Bergamac is not abandoned. Still there are at least 3 people living there without electricity. Secondly, Bergamac is a very clean river. Luckily, I didn't have to boil water. I just filled my bottles in and now I'm going to hike miles away from here. Thirdly, this place is potentially suitable for building a dugout or even a log cabin because there are a lot of pine trees over here. They are straight, they are good. There is water again. But what I do not like is bears. A man who is living there, he told me that last year there was a bear attack and a woman was killed when she went mushroom picking. Last year, I did not expect something like this to happen. Now I'm worried a little bit, of course. I'll have to listen to music loudly, maybe to sing something, because you know, when you are hiking in the wild, the worst thing you can do is to do it silently. If you know that there are wild animals, you have to be loud. You have to listen to music. You have to do at least something that makes sound. The louder, the better, because bears do not like it. But now it's the middle of July and there are berries in the woods, so I think that bears are basically not hungry. But still, you know, danger exists, and that's really bad. That is what is called a hunter's signal. It is a little rocket launcher. You put the round here. And after that you can shoot it like this. It produces a lot of noise and flame, so basically that's a thing that I can use to let bears know that I am not so vulnerable, you know. I also have a bear gas balloon, a special one. But I forgot to take it to this hike. Shit. What I'm gonna do now is to find a place over here to light a bonfire and prepare something to eat. Now it's 2 o'clock and I didn't have breakfast this time, so now I'm pretty exhausted and I really need something to put in my stomach. After that I'm going to hike approximately 16 kilometers to that side, and this road will lead me to a village called Rezany. That's a place where I'm going to find a bus that goes to Omsk city, where I'm living now. So probably tomorrow I will be able to reach Rezany and go home. Of course, if I do not find any bears, or if they don't find me. Look, there is a moose over there. Right there in the forest, running away. A big one, an adult. They can be dangerous as well. They can kick you both with front and back legs. I know that statistically more people suffer from moose attacks than from bear attacks. Lots of gadflies flying around me. I guess they all came with that moose, because you know, moose is an animal that attracts them. And I'm another animal that attracts them. Gadflies are irritating and big, but not so irritating as normal mosquitoes. If I had to choose, I would for sure choose gadflies. I had to prepare a place for bonfire very thoroughly, because this forest, as locals told me, it was burnt last year. So it is dangerous. It's very dry, though it was a rain 2 days ago. I'm not gonna make a big bonfire, just a little one to prepare some porridge or something else. The pot is on fire, and I made it not to fall down, for sure. I'm going to prepare some porridge now and eat it with sausages and dry bread. And for the dinner, I guess I'll have my dried soup. Appreciate how big it is. It is the third ant house that I see on my way, and they are all so big. 2 feet high. And the road I'm walking on looks like this. Not so bad. It's supposed to go almost to the motorway, so I hope tomorrow I will be there. Forest gates are so pretty, aren't they? Wow! Look at this. Another big boy. A bunch of logs being prepared to be taken out of this forest. That's a curse of Russian taiga, actually. A lot of woods are being cut off, and there is no restoration in most cases. This plant in Russia is called borshchevik. Have no idea if you have it in the US or in Europe. The thing is, they were grown back into USSR because they are a perfect plant to serve as a food for cows and other cattle. But soon they found out that borshchevik is poisonous, and if a person touches it, he has injuries. Severe injuries, like chemical burn or something like this. Actually, a lot of people suffer from borshchevik each year, and it's very difficult to get rid of it. So now it is another curse of Western Siberia and Russia in general. From the forest, I go to a large field of fireweed. A very large one. Quite nice. A sort of a pink sea. And there is no road anymore, unfortunately. So now I am approximately 5 miles away from a Rezany village. Today I won't be able to get there, It's getting darker. Soon I'll have to have rest. The second day is over and I'm already chilling out in my tent. I had a little adventure with it. First I installed the inner part of it and the tent itself. After that I tried to sleep and failed because all the gadflies and mosquitoes that are living here, they were between the inner part and the tent, producing terrible noise. So I had to remove a tent and to stay in the inner part. I don't think it's gonna rain this night, at least the weather forecast that I checked a couple of days ago did not predict any rains. So hopefully night will go well. As for my plans for tomorrow, well, first of all I'll have to go back to Bergamak Creek. It's 1 mile away from the place where I'm staying, just to have some water. And after that I need to pass, I guess 7 miles to Rizany. I plan to be there by 2 o'clock tomorrow, so that I'll be able to catch a bus that goes to my city. I don't want to stay here for 2 more days. Good night, guys. The third day morning, I hadn't slept at all. I don't know why, but it was kind of cold because I wasn't able to put a tent. Had to sleep in the inner part only. As for plans to today, after having another cold breakfast with dry fruits, by the way, after that I'm going to go back to Bergamak Creek, get some water, and hike away of here very quickly because I need to be in Rizany by 2 o'clock, and it's kind of hard. Somebody takes care of ant piles. That's not the first barrier I can see. I don't know why there are a lot of ant piles here. And ants are for sure not the animals that need to be protected in a red book or something. I'm on my way to Rizany. I'm close to civilization now, so these are first signs of it. I really like such forest benches. Nice place to have rest. Preparing to take new logs out. These are tractors used for taking logs, widely used in forest industry, invented back in the USSR, of course. I'm not an eco-activist, but this looks pretty sad. Quite a big part of forest is cut down. You can write in comments what is the situation with wood cutting in your country. This hike is over. I'm next to a motorway and I hope today I will be able to go back home. Don't miss me, in a week I'm going to have another hike, a long one, and we are going to visit real hermits who live in taiga in an abandoned village called Knyazivka. It will be a long way to the north, to a border of Vasyugan swamp. If you didn't know, Vasyugan is the largest swamp system on the planet. So that's gonna be interesting. See you on my channel.